Hello, my YouTube friends and family, Instagrammers. I love you too. I don't discriminate between social media outlets. No, I don't, but this is your boy AMJ, and today my hair is puffy. It's because I washed it. I don't like to wash my hair every day because then it... And thank you for all the comments I've been receiving about the new hairdo. I did let it grow it out. I didn't think I could, but it's getting past the ugly phase, so that makes me happy. I want to thank everybody that's been watching my videos. Please be sure to hit the thumbs up button if you like this video. This video is going to talk about the number one thing, the most important thing, my opinion, but I think the general opinion, the one thing also that a lot of people don't like to tell you right off the bat because they want to sell you their $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 systems. They want you to come to their classes and buy their books and hear all their shit. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with getting a mentor, but one thing that a lot of them fail to say right out of the gate is, and I'm gonna tell you in a moment, hit that subscribe button. It really means a lot to me. My numbers are going up. And just to let you know, you guys have been watching my videos about, talk a little bit about advertising, putting yourself out there, getting the marketing going. I just got a phone call from a young lady here in Hollywood. She watched one of my videos on commercial leases and things to look for in those leases. And, you know, she picked up the phone and gave me a call, and I'm helping her out with a deal. It takes a lot of guts. And I just want to add one thing to that video because she wasn't aware. She asked me what my rate is. Let me just let you know, and I'll put this in the next few videos so that I can keep repeating this message. I've said it before. Realtors don't charge money. If a realtor's charging you money off the bat, get another realtor. All right. If you're representing a tenant, because I do rentals, if you're renting an apartment, that's fine. I rent leases, commercial leases. I'm doing a deal right now. For those of you who've been following me, I got four doctors that I'm putting up in a beautiful space in Beverly Hills. And we are on the other side of that hump getting our terms together. I'm up against Douglas Emmett, which is a huge firm out in Southern California. And that have actually been really great to work with. And representing buyers also, commission is paid for by the landlord or the owner. The commission is already negotiated, predetermined by whoever's representing the landlord or whoever's representing the seller. And on that note, nobody gets paid until a deal is closed. So if you ever need help finding a home, finding a rental property, finding a commercial space, hit up an agent. Hit me up if you're in LA. It doesn't cost you anything. It's already paid for by the landlord. All right, so today's video, quickly, this is really quick because I'm at the 3-minute mark. It's Rebecca's birthday. We got shit to do today and I'm gonna fly on out of here. But the number one thing to building wealth, the most important thing, is not being in debt. I'm not talking about good debt, all right? There's a big difference between having, you know, $50,000 worth of available credit on your credit cards and you're at the $49,750 mark, right? That's high. I've been there. 99%. It's terrible for your credit. There's a big difference between a guy that's got $50,000 worth of credit to his name and 49,000 utilization as opposed to a guy that's got $150 million worth of debt in his name and all of that is in net worth. Apartments, condos, commercials, investments, passive income. I'll talk a lot about passive income for the rest of my life. Hopefully that'll be a long life. But when it comes to debt, people that put shit on their credit cards, if you're buying beer on a credit card, unless you're paying that credit card off every month in full, not the minimum payment, because that shit will take you forever to pay off, not the minimum payment, but you're paying off the entire balance every month, then you shouldn't be drinking beer. If you're traveling on a credit card, and I love traveling, unless you're using it for the points, you shouldn't be racking up debt. I know a lot of times credit cards are right there. They seem like free money, but they're not. A lot of them are charging you 29, 24, 15, 30% interest. Let me tell you something. If you signed a contract with a friend of yours right now saying, hey, I'm gonna loan you $5,000 and I'm gonna charge you 30% interest, I believe that's called loan sharking. We go to jail for that shit. But Chase, Citibank, Wells Fargo, all these credit card companies, they can charge us 30% and it's legal. Then you default on a payment, then they hit you with fees. You're pretty much in debt to them for the rest of your life if you're making minimum payments. The number one thing that you need to do in order to start generating wealth is stop using your credit cards, stop building bad debt, terrible debt. Credit card debt, it's the worst one. The only other one that's really bad, and it's really funny to me because, hey, college, it's a really important thing. People talk all the time about getting educated. Try to default on your student loan. Impossible. The government will ride your ass for the rest of your life if you default on your student loans. You're better off committing crimes. All right, that's my tip. If you want to start building wealth, get out of debt. Try to stay above the red, right? We all get into debt. We all have issues, things that come up. We all sometimes mismanage our money. The faster you learn to manage your money, the faster you learn to, you know, just keep an eye on your spending. If you're in a tight spot, understood. Drinking beer, going out and partying, and racking up a credit card is not a good reason to be whipping out the credit card. Now, if you're buying equipment, if you're buying gear to invest in yourself and invest in a business, awesome. Do that. Make sure that you're going to be making some money on the backside. Make sure you're going to be able to pay off that debt. But if you're picking up tabs for your friends because your friends are broke or they're having hard times or you're taking these lavish trips, or you're financing cars that you're not ready to make car payments on, this is bad debt. They're liabilities. They don't help you. In the long run, they can hurt you. And by the time you realize, shit, I want to start making some moves and making some money, people pull your credit report to see what kind of person you are, right? And then you got some bad credit history. Nobody's going to loan you money. And if they do, you're going to pay a higher interest rate than everybody else. You heard that story about Warren Buffett. He borrowed like, I don't know, $300 million for 0%. They loaned him money for free, $300 million. Why? Because he's got like A++, three, I don't know, 900 FICO score. I think the highest you can get is 850. Warren's got a 900. All right. If this video speaks to you, leave me a comment. Hit the thumbs up button. And let the internet know that this guy is fantastic. I think that the entire planet needs to know this. And leave me a comment. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up. Shout out to that one lady who picked up the phone and gave me a call. She didn't even call me to do business. She was calling me because she wanted some help, and I was happy to help her. But during that conversation, I said, you know, these are all things I can help you with. And she said, Andy, how much do you charge? And I said, it's free. The landlord's going to pay for that. And she said, oh, shit. Then why don't you do it for me? And I'm like, yeah, I'm going to do it for you. So remember, don't spend any money on shit you don't need, on your credit cards especially. And B, you shouldn't be paying. Don't worry about paying a real estate agent if you're going to get represented on the buyer side, landlord and all that stuff. All that shit is taken care of. You should not be charged any money up front until the transaction is closed. And even then, it's just on the landlord seller side on the back end. You're good. Call your agents. Use agents. We're really helpful people. We see a lot of shit. A lot of people do some funky shit out there. It's good to have somebody on your side representing you and working with you to help facilitate the process. And if nothing at all, to help educate you, because that's what we're here to do. Educate each other. I learn, you learn. Don't spend money on shit. Number one way to generate wealth. Don't spend money on shit. If you get that, I'm gonna play this video for my kid. Have a good one.